Jerry Lane Enterprises present Paradise, Louisiana. With Gary Rispone and Don Dubuque. Paradise, Louisiana is also brought to you by Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Venice Car Wash and Oil Change, Cracker Barrel Convenience Stores. We have more than you expect. Always fresh, never frozen, Raising Cane's. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana, Louisiana Fish Fry Products, Demco, First South Farm Credit, Pro Drive Outboards, H&E Equipment Services, an equipment company run by equipment people, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Welcome to this week's edition of Paradise, Louisiana. Here we are at Spillway Sportsman, just across the bridge, and I'm Gary Rispone, but this is not Don Dubuque.
And yeah, and he's a lot cooler than we are today, can I tell you?
I tell you what, Ed, there's no need to introduce this guy. He's probably been on TV more than anything, not only with his cooking, but he is an excellent outdoorsman. KD, I can't tell you how honored I am to have you today.
Man, look, I'm glad to be here. I would like to be with Don, Alaska, 40-something degrees.
See,
I mean,
you've been there before.
Oh, God, man. Yes.
You've been
amazing.
There.
Only place I ever saw that I honestly think could parallel Louisiana, only for a few months. But, buddy, when things warm up out there, those fish, they just get crazy.
Well,
so I'm sure he's having fun.
He's on his Cajun invasion, but before he left, he did a little offshore fishing with Daryl Carpenter out of Grand Island. He was with his daughter and her friend, and they did well. They did well, and so we'll bring some of that to you. Annual trip to start up.
Wait, I got to preface this now. You hear the word retreat. Normally you think about, well, I'm going on a retreat. It's a very quiet thing. You spend a few hours a day meditating.
Right.
Well, this is a Cajun retreat, okay? Them Cajuns go down there. They can't be quiet, especially some friends of mine. So kind of tell us what all y'all did, because, man, that sounds like my kind of retreat.
This is the third annual. Father Mitch Pacwa. He's on Catholic Community Radio. He's on Nationwide Radio. He's originally from Chicago, and now he's in Birmingham. He's on a national TV show, the Catholic Channel, and he's a very big outdoorsman. And this is the third year he came down here. He's been out here twice to Louisiana, hog hunting. It was a hogging retreat. So I don't want to be phony and everybody say, ain't no way that guy going to be quiet. And you're right, because everybody saw me on the island. They had so much going on. Again, Bridgeside was packed. People catching fish on the bridge.
Crabs in the surf, I hear they've been wearing them out.
They had a memorial, Mike Bourgeois, Big Daddy Memorial Tournament at Bridgeside. Like you said, a lot of crabs we caught crabs. At the retreat, when I first got there, they had ball shrimp, crabs. Every day, Father says a mass, but to say the mass before you eat, so you know it's really good. You're hungry, you're thinking about that food. You can see it, and you're trying to hurry up and get through mass.
We get more responsibly oriented by the meal.
Let me tell you what his sermon. There's no being quiet because I wouldn't have been there. And I couldn't stay there the whole time. I made the round. They had the legislative rodeo, CCA legislative rodeo. I got a few scenes for that, and I got to talk to Bodie White, who caught an 84-pound amberjack. And his wife, and they caught some. Still in state waters, they still catch the snapper. So, KD, I mentioned if I don't need nothing, but most important at all, you know, 2 weeks ago, we made a wish to fish back in Venice, and that's always the very most popular thing we do. I enjoy the most.
Giving back, bringing people along in what we do. You know, we're blessed to have one of the most amazing outdoor cultures in the world. In fact, we got a little frog in to tease you about here in a little bit, both from the kind you eat. But guys, if you check this out, this is a story just to show you the legacy we pass on with wish to fish and people that need a hand up, to just some Louisiana boys getting up there on Kentucky Lake and kind of kicking some tail, can I tell you? Not just one team, but they were scared of three or four teams that whole time because they were always right up in there.
Well, we're going to let them tell the whole story.
Oh, yeah, we don't want to break that fire.
That's the tease. And you can imagine, you know, it's, I always tell kids when we're playing, we win a city championship, league championship. You know, when you get to the big ones, you win a state championship. I never was on a state championship team. My girls were. But when you say national champion, and probably in no other place in the world they have bad fits like this, high school kids, that's probably a world champion. So stay tuned. We're watching Paradise, Louisiana. And it's a shame, you know, he come here today, but he ain't cooked. He took time off from his busy schedule.
Oh, and I left the pralines on the counter. I had him some pralines just to kind of sweeten him up.
You know I'm diabetic now. I can't tell you. Dirty dog. Stay tuned. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. We're at Spillway Sportsman. Remodel hunting season's down just right down the road. And they packed in the front right now. People going through their
boats. It's just a bridge. Get over it.
That's what we talk about.
It takes true grit to wake up every morning dedicated to a higher standard of work. At H&E Equipment Services, we're leveraging our national fleet of equipment with a local approach, working closely with customers to understand their needs and provide them reliability, fair prices, and the support of a first-class service team. We're an equipment company run by equipment people. Where others stop, we continue. H&E Equipment Services, the higher standard in equipment rental, sales, parts, and service.
I'm Charlie Hayes, I go to Dunham School, and you're watching Paradise Louisiana.
And I'm on my fourth Chevy Silverado pickup. It's always been
Chevy. Hey, you know I've had 4 Camaros and 5 Corvettes. Got them all from Jerry Lane.
We're proud to be a Jerry Lane family. Always be too. You can count on Jerry.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. We're at Bridgeside Marina in Grand Isle with Captain Daryl Carpenter of RealScreamers.com. And Daryl, we're going to get out there today and catch what you call some Gulf of Mexico exotics. And that really is the future of the charter boat industry, guys, isn't it?
Well, until they get all this mess that's straightened out, that's, you know, encompassing triggerfish, red snapper, and everything else, yeah, we've got to look for other non-regulated or not so tightly regulated species.
And where's that information coming from? Is that something you guys are researching, or are you getting some help from some agency to identify those species that are, could be targets?
No, it's just, it's what we're targeting now is probably a little bit more work. It's they're a little bit deeper fish. It takes a little more commitment. It's stuff that we haven't just had to target in the past. But now we're being forced to look for alternatives. And so we're going to those species, the groupers, the deep water groupers, and, you know, the grunts and the porgies and that kind of stuff. Something that we can actually put in a box.
And a little different style of fishing. We'll take you down there and show you how we did it right here on Paradise, Louisiana.
Oh! Hey, now it's all got me. Go to the motor well if you have to.
Yeah, I'll get him right here. There he comes. Hey, look at that fish. Yeah. All right, red snapper's closed. Amberjack's not open yet. Triggerfish is closed. Is there anything to catch out here? You bet. We're going to show you where and how.
Well, things more like the red porgies, things more like the groupers, the various groupers and so forth. They're a little bit harder to target. You need better conditions. You need, you know, the right conditions. And they're much deeper. You got to have somebody dedicated to fish it. But you can certainly fill a box and get away from the federally managed things. the yellow edge groupers, the barrel fish, the porgies, that type of stuff. And it's something that we're having to turn to because the feds are otherwise pushing us out of this fishery.
There he is.
We got a single one.
All right. That's an offshore exotic, the red porgy.
Mangroves have always been a good fallback for us, but it's something that up to this point we haven't had to look very much for this year because our rip lines have been so great. We've had a great and wonderful dolphin year, rip lines everywhere. Unfortunately, right now the blue water has moved way out, so yes, but mangroves are a good fill-in during that hole between snapper season's closed, but amberjack season hadn't opened up, and all the other controversy with the triggerfish and everything else. Barrel fish is also known as barrel grouper. We did not find one today, but we've been doing really well on them. They're supposed to be the finest eating grouper in the Gulf. I've heard many people refer to them that they taste like lobster meat.
Yellow edge grouper, yum.
Yellow edge grouper has been gaining a lot of popularity with everything going on with the red snapper and stuff. They're a deep water grouper. They're caught anywhere between 400 to 800 feet deep, and we're starting to target those. I mean, it's we're having to evolve and change our fishery just so we can survive in this industry.
Stop.
There it is.
Another dang-gum jack. You and your jacks.
What you have there is, oh, an angry but undersized amberjack. They have to be a little bit bigger than this to keep.
But a lot of the stuff is just trial and error stuff that we've seen. For instance, I mentioned pulling the ribs. I don't pull a rip without my sounder going full blast. And with the new modern day sounders, if you pass something, you can go back and mark it. And we find a lot of stuff while we're pulling rips and doing that type of stuff and just watching your sounder. And then you go back and investigate it later, and some marks are good, some marks you don't get anything off of.
One last offshore tip. If you're catching mangroves or you're catching grouper, you pretty well can catch them anywhere you like and keep them. But if you're fishing state waters, for species that's only open in state waters like redfish and red snapper, make sure you don't travel into offshore waters because you will be in violation.
Who doesn't want to save money on fuel? Now, Shell and the Fuel Rewards Network are putting you in control of how much you pay for fuel. Simply buy whatever's on your shopping list. Clothes, groceries, even dinner out. And earn cents per gallon savings at participating retailers nationwide. Now, fuel prices are in your hands. So why wait? Sign up at FuelRewards.com today and turn shopping power into saving power.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
My name is Don Wagon. I'm down in Venice, Louisiana, at the Venice Marina, and you are watching Paradise, Louisiana.
The excitement builds for the 2015 CCA Star Tournament. This year's Star is loaded with new ways to win your share of over $1.5 million in prizes, including Tag Trout Division and more paid places for heaviest trout.
Believe it or not, I actually won.
Over 108 days of fishing with over 25 inshore and offshore divisions. We have something for everyone. Be the first to catch a tag redfish and win a new Chevy Silverado. Enter now for just $30 by registering at ccastar.com. Share in the passion and serve our coast.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
At Jerry Lane, they rolled the red carpet out for me.
It's always been Jerry.
You know what? It's tradition, it's family, and that's what keeps us coming back to Jerry Lane.
Get the lane, get the lane. Get the lane, get the lane. Get the lane, get the lane.
We're a Jerry Lane family.
Always be too.
Cloud.
Christina Lorio, and we are here for the 2015 Wish to Fish. I'm with the Miracle League of Marine New Orleans, and this is our fifth year fishing. And we're here, down here in Venice, and we're ready to go fishing.
You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Jeff Fouché with Delta Dawn Guide Service.
Captain Dan Dix, MLC Charters.
Chris Wilson, Rivers End Outfitters, Venice, Louisiana.
Lenny Stevens, Venice Sportsman's Lodge, Venice, Louisiana.
Captain Bula, owner-operator, Real Tight Fishing in Venice, Louisiana.
Dennis Barwell, DB Charters.
Captain Lloyd Landry with Outcast Fishing Charters.
Captain C.T. Williams, Big Fish TV.
Captain Rock, also with Real Tight Fishing Guide Service in Venice, Louisiana.
Captain Jarrett with Real Tight Fishing Guide Service.
This is gonna be the best day of my life. My life. This is gonna be the best day of my life. My life. This is gonna be the best day of my life.
The third year in a row we've had bad weather, and I'll tell you, if you watch the video and the footage, you would never know that it was bad weather. I mean, we get the kids out and we fish along the dock if it's too bad, but the guides looked at the radar and said, you know what, we're going to get them out there. The weather calmed down, and they got them out and put them on some fish, so I think every boat caught fishing, and kids were excited.
Three fish. That was a good trip, then. How big were they?
Caught that big redfish.
This one, he's awesome. He broke the hook.
What?
Yeah. It was awesome because I caught my first fish. I caught my first keeper fish, and it was a 2-in-1 fish. And then also I caught another one, which was huge.
You got the big one so far.
I caught him.
We got three, huh?
Three. Man, we're the world's greatest fishing team, right?
Say Uncle Billy.
Yes, indeed. You should have seen the fish he caught.
Is that big?
Yep.
Big?
Yep. Wait, how big is it, Sean? That big? That's right.
We caught 11 fish, 9 red fishes, and 2 tilapias.
11 red fish, tilapia, and that's all. Bye. With all of my friends from Miracle League, you know, I love to fish. I still have my fishing pole from last year. I still have a lot of stuff from last year. Especially, I love Captain Rock. He was my captain this year, and he was my captain last year, and from ever on now I come, he's going to be my captain.
Gary, I do have a lot of help. You know, obviously, I could not do this by myself, and you're right. The people that come out here, every cent that is put into Wish to Fish goes back to the events, goes back to the kids, the captains, the volunteers, but everybody that, my staff or personnel that have been helping me since the day one, you know, they've just been doing it out of the kindness of their heart, and I think that's why it works so well.
My name is Torres Williams. I'm with Hotard Motor Coaches. We're responsible for bringing the kids out here from New Orleans and from the North Shore area. Here, fish stories already, so I'm amazed about how all the big fish, everybody has big fish.
When we were unloading the fish, I counted about at least 13, about 5 red fish, and the rest were about sheep heads.
Are you going to eat that fish? I'm gonna cook that fish for you.
Mommy!
Oh, that'll work.
I think this day has been awesome. I appreciate everything that Miracle League and Wish a Fish has done for our family. It has been great. Thank y'all so much. We appreciate everything. And Captain Jeff was a great host. We appreciated being on his boat.
We've been involved with the Miracle League for the past year. He plays baseball and basketball. And he loves getting out doing anything that's, especially anything out of the ordinary. And coming out here fishing, we don't get to do this too often. So we come out here and do whatever we can with the Miracle League, and we just enjoy spending time together.
This is a wonderful event. Each one is unique. You know, we have different groups of kids at each Wish to Fish event. And this one, you know, you walk away going, you just hope that we all don't take this for granted, because seeing these kids out here and having fun fishing.
Louisiana Farm Bureau Insurance doesn't hire celebrities to push auto coverage. We think people might want to make decisions based on service and savings, not because that guy from that show says it's a good idea. Instead of faces you know from your TV, we offer faces you know from your neighborhood, because we're based in Louisiana with local agents right in your town. That's really the only thing we want to be famous for. Louisiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Real service, real people.
Who doesn't want to save money on fuel? Now, Shell and the Fuel Rewards Network are putting you in control of how much you pay for fuel. Simply buy whatever's on your shopping list. Clothes, groceries, even dinner out. And earn cents per gallon savings at participating retailers nationwide. Now, fuel prices are in your hands. So why wait? Sign up at FuelRewards.com today and turn shopping power into saving power.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
Watch Paradise, Louisiana.
When you're ready to really enjoy life at a slower pace, become a landowner. First South Farm Credit specializes in financing and refinancing land, but not just for farmers. They offer loans to purchase timberland, hunting and fishing, or recreational property. Their experience in land, timber, and loans set them apart from standard lending institutions. Contact a First South Farm Credit loan officer for more information. First South Farm Credit, a specialized rural land investment lender helping you realize your dream.
Come to the family-owned and operated Cassius Casino in Port Allen today, where the Vegas-style video poker machines are ready for your entertainment. Cassius Casino is the finest, cleanest, classiest casino around. And Cash's 50-style diner is now serving seafood daily, along with your favorite home-cooked specials 24/7. Hey, Cash's is fun. Cash's is exciting. So come to the unsinkable Cash's Casino in Port Allen. Over the river, 2 miles west of exit 151.
This is Father Mitch Pacwa from Birmingham, Alabama. I work up at Eternal Word Television Network. And you are watching Paradise Television. And you're going to spice up your life when you spice up your food.
Nick Sheldon, Zachary, Louisiana.
Jim Blowen, Baton Rouge.
Jeff Bearden, Birmingham, Alabama.
Louis Prejean, Catholic Radio, Baton Rouge.
Jimmy Hebert, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Tony Nikolic, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Michael Scholl, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Peter Scholl, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Julius Laurent, Laplace, Louisiana.
John Melanson, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. River Road Coffee Company.
Fred Gwynn from Baton Rouge.
Paradise Louisiana.
Here we are. Another rodeo here. Riverside Marina is for Big Daddy. Mike, Big Daddy Bourgeois. Ben, Bourgeois.
Yes, sir.
I see all these Vienna sausages everywhere, and I was just curious. I know he was very popular. He fished all the time. He had a bad disease. He knew nothing holding back. I've been talking about him. I've been around here all day, and everybody's talking about Big Daddy. Well, y'all know my penchant for food. I'm also a Vienna sausage man. So in honor of Big Daddy,
yep,
I'm gonna take his brother right now, and I'm gonna they hold my nose. Believe that I love this thing. Me and my dog had him every morning. Get ready to eat one in honor of Big Daddy. Bourgeois.
You love those when he's fishing.
You ready?
It's great, nutritious, it's filling, it's good for you. Let's do it.
All the vitamins. But tell me something. You said your brother, when he was really, he takes the whole can.
Take the whole thing from the top.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to take a little. You don't mind eating that? I'm going to take a little
too. It's all good stuff. It's nutritious.
Oh, I'm going to let you put your hands in first.
Oh, I got a good one.
Don't tell him where
the center one is the best. Just so you know, the center one.
I got like the center. Like the center steak.
Yes.
Right there.
Cheers.
This for you, Big Mike. Mm-hmm. No wonder they call it Big Daddy.
Not just delicious, it's good for you, too.
Adam from Slidell.
What's the name again?
Adam.
What's the last name?
Pearson.
Adam Pearson from Slidell.
Kevin Pearson from Slidell.
State Representative Kevin Pearson. Slidell, Louisiana.
Robin White from Central.
Modi White from Central.
Central. I want to hear the story of how Miss Robin caught that.
The one on the end over there?
The one on the end, right over there. Tell me real quick, how was the struggle catching and ending that fish?
It was extremely difficult, but it didn't take me but a few minutes.
About 30 minutes.
You're about a politician. That was good.
About 30
Congratulations.
Minutes.
Congratulations. I know y'all got a winner somewhere in there.
Yeah.
Bodie, that's a big one, you?
Yeah, that was the first fish we caught. It was 84 pounds. It was a struggle. I've never caught one that big. Caught some 60s, but never
I've never seen one that big.
It's a pretty fish. Yeah. It was a good day.
Stay tuned for more Paradise, Louisiana.
I can't believe y'all brought me out in this blind and we ain't got no food.
Don't worry, Gary. This will be over quick.
Man, I'm hungry.
Get out, Gary. Here they come. That dog loves to hunt.
I really like hunting, but you know what I really love?
I know, Gary. Food.
Now I can eat. Cane's, the official chicken of Louisiana Outdoors.
You're watching Paradise, Louisiana, buddy.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
As members of a Touchstone Energy cooperative, we've all got a job to do. And the more we work together, the more we save. That's the power of your co-op membership.
Demco, your Touchstone Energy cooperative.
Welcome to Paradise, Louisiana. We're out here, got a couple of pro drive boats. We're gonna go out there and see if we can catch some frogs. We had some luck last weekend catching frogs two nights in a row. We hope this rain hadn't messed us up real bad. Anxious to see what's gonna happen.
See what you got there, buddy. That's what I'm talking about. Good job.
Back up.
Wait a minute, come back up there, y'all.
Hey, bring
me up.
All right.
Breakfast
on. Got it.
See what you got, PJ.
All right.
Good job, baby. Good job.
Yeah, you got him. Back up. Back up.
See what you got.
Woo!
All right. All right.
Got it. Back up.
Get out there and grab it. Good job, baby. Woo. Oh, queen, baby.
You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Excitement builds for the 2015 CCA Star Tournament. This year's Star is loaded with new ways to win your share of over $1.5 million in prizes, including Tag Trout Division and more paid places for heaviest trout.
Believe it or not, I actually won.
Over 108 days of fishing with over 25 inshore and offshore divisions. We have something for everyone. Be the first to catch a tag redfish and win a new Chevy Silverado. Enter now for just $30 by registering at ccastar.com. Share in the passion and serve our coast.
You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. On this boat here is all the guy from the Purple Night, St. Aug, St. Aug, St. Aug.
Ask me about my Tempur-Pedic.
Ask me how fast I fall asleep.
Why not talk to someone who's sleeping on the most highly recommended bed in America?
Ask me about staying asleep.
Tempur-Pedic owners are more satisfied than owners of any traditional mattress brand.
Ask me how it feels after 10 years.
Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America.
Ask about Tempur-Pedic at Olin's, where you know you always get the guaranteed low price.
Olin's is the only store in Baton Rouge and Lafayette with the full line of Tempur-Pedics.
When you're ready to really enjoy life at a slower pace, become a landowner. First South Farm Credit specializes in financing and refinancing land, but not just for farmers. They offer loans to purchase timberland, hunting and fishing, or recreational property. Their experience in land, timber, and loans set them apart from standard lending institutions. Contact a First South Farm Credit loan officer for more information. First South Farm Credit, a specialized rural land investment lender helping you realize your dream.
Welcome back to Spillway Sportsman, just right across the bridge here in Brulee, and we got some news items to come up. Most of them is events right now. You know, we always talking about rodeos, and we try to make as many as we can, or at least get the report. So I'm going to ask y'all people down there in the Cameron Pass, Empire South Pass, Tarpon Rodeo will be coming up Thursday through Saturday, and then just this weekend, August 7th to the 9th. It's going to be the Hercules Rodeo down in Houma. Also this weekend, we got the Louisiana Outdoor Riders Association conference in Morgan City, Louisiana. They're going to be giving out the awards for the youth hunter and fishing this year, both boys and girls. They're going to have Fish of the Year. All of them will be going on at the Holiday Inn. And by the way, we got a few of our team members, Gary Krause and a couple of others, a good old boy there, Chris Lecoq, you know, that's producing yep. this and telling me to hurry up. He's also going to get an award this week. Don't know exactly what it is, but this weekend we'll bring you that next week. KD, I see one on here. It happened to be on your birthday.
My birthday. Can you imagine
the
that?
The inaugural Ascension Area Angler's Bass Open.
Well, it's going to be in the basin, and what we're trying to do is defray some of the costs to help Jamie Lesh as he competes, as he moves up into BASS leagues. And it's going to be great. Spillway starting the fall. We could get a bite. That could very well be the bite we've been waiting for all year long, if you've been chomping it a bit like I have.
You're going to run David Cavell's number on there, and have other people you can call. So that's some bigger. That's way down the line right now. CCA Louisiana, August 14th, 15th, the same time, by the way, as Ride the Bull. I'll tell these guys how they're doing this, but this is a big thing. It's Sycamore Point, so we're going to run it on the screen. They got numbers you can call. It's called Specs and Spots. It's a tournament. Ida and Vermilion Bay. So let's see if we got anything before we miss. Anything else you want to say?
But one thing, that Ride the Bull, if you want to see something amazing, just get up there and watch. It was almost 300 kayaks?
No, that was the first they went for. Last year it was 729.
729.
I don't know if they're going to break any world records, but it's going to be big. And Chris will be there the whole time, and we'll be there for the weigh-in. Chris actually fishes it, and he goes out there, and we take pictures. We got the drones. We take the pictures. What it reminded me of last year with 700 was, looked like somebody threw a bunch of crayons out there. All different color kayaks, and they were bumping into each other. So
that's
2 weeks away now.
Going on. The biggest thing is you showed them all about it, but I'm getting plumb pumped up because we get ready to bring on some Louisiana heroes, young heroes.
You better think you believe it.
You think so?
My heroes, you better believe it. We had a lot, you and I both had a lot to do with these kids, but,
But let me tell you something.
Like what the people do over there in the Southwest.
Reinvest, all right?
That's what
these guys say. Get a chance to go out there and live a dream, and let me tell you something, they did it. Hey, y'all stay tuned, you're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Don't go nowhere, because it's getting ready to get really informative.
Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with four electrolytes lost in sweat. Ion 4, the complete sports drink.
You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
It takes true grit to wake up every morning dedicated to a higher standard of work. At H&E Equipment Services, we're leveraging our national fleet of equipment with a local approach, working closely with customers to understand their needs and provide them reliability, fair prices, and the support of a first-class service team. We're an equipment company run by equipment people. Where others stop, we continue. H&E Equipment Services, the higher standard in equipment rental, sales, parts, and service.
It's that time of year to get your gear. Visit ParadiseLouisiana.com and click shop to get your official merchandise online. Whether hunting, fishing, or just enjoying all Louisiana has to offer, get geared up at ParadiseLouisiana.com.
Come to the family-owned and operated Cassius Casino in Port Allen today, where the Vegas-style video poker machines are ready for your entertainment. Cassius Casino is the finest, cleanest, classiest casino around. And Cassius 50-style diner is now serving seafood daily, along with your favorite home-cooked specials 24/7. Hey, Cassius is fun. Cassius is exciting. So come to the unsinkable Cassius Casino in Port Allen. Over the river 2 miles west of exit 151.
GM Cable, locally owned and operated since 1984, has grown from a one-man shop to a family company with more than 90 employees. For more than two decades, GM Cable has established itself as one of the most trusted contractors in Louisiana. GM Cable specializes in fiber optic installation, video surveillance, directional boring, aerial and outdoor construction, and much more. Log on to gmcable.com to learn more about this rock-solid local company. GM Cable, improving the standards of communication.
Hey, welcome back to Spillway Sportsman here in Brulee. And KD, you've been wanting to ask these boys the questions right now. We were taping. Alex Heinz, Justin Watts,
sir.
National champions. Congratulations.
Louisiana was well represented, as we normally are when it comes to the national fishing scene. But everybody, when you're leading, wants to know what you're fishing with. Nobody had a clue because y'all didn't have a rod on your deck, did you?
No, sir. We kept everything a secret until the final days.
Now, y'all got thrown together by happenstance. Y'all say it's kind of like the luck of the draw. But y'all have done well together, kind of like the opposites attract. Y'all adapted and did something. The water was rising. Everybody else, this is a deep water lake. Nobody's thinking about fishing with frogs. But those bass are just like you and I. Wherever there's a cheeseburger, Gary can relate to this. If there's a cheeseburger, we're going to know where it's at. They were smart enough not to ever let anybody know what they were fishing with. Because if anybody saw that frog, they know you're not fishing in 80-foot of water.
We teased this last week. We showed y'all on stage and all this. Did you watch the show last week?
Yes, sir, I watched it.
You lying?
I'm
lying. You told me you just did it. I'm going to lie.
I'm going to watch it.
Alex, did you watch the show?
No, sir, we were too busy last week during competition, so we didn't get a chance.
Boy, they were fishing again. See how you lie? You're going to get a lot of boys. You just like
good fishing.
He just like them weather watts over there in the lake. But look, now, let's show them the baits y'all were doing. And
well, for me, I was mostly throwing a little tube, a black and blue tube. Didn't really matter which one. It just had a flipping in there, and most of the time, as soon as it dropped into the water, you had a fish. But if not, you had to just work it back real quick, and that seemed to be the key for me. We were throwing a little quarter-ounce tungsten weight, pegging it, and then with a 4-aught trocar hook, and then just Texas rigging it.
Tell me about the frog, and tell me how you was doing it. Were you coming? A lot of times, the old frogs, you just keep them coming in, or You walked the dog, or how did you use that?
I couldn't get a bite unless I made it walk. If it wouldn't walk, you wouldn't get a bite. I don't think necessarily it was looking like a frog. I think it was more of a shad looking, because I never heard a frog since I was there. Black's always good during early morning, during
it's
the
so
day.
Wet,
we also flipped a missile D-bomb when the sun got up and they quit really hitting top water. We tried to do this and slow down and try to get bigger bites. The first 2 days, we didn't fish long. We fished to about 10:30 and left our spot. We had 20 pounds by 10:30, and we tried to conserve our fish so we'd have some left for the final day.
I just like to thank all my friends and family, everyone that was helped support our little benefit tournament. I'd like to thank some of my sponsors, Lucas Oil, Front to Back Boat Service, Denali Rise, and all the other sponsors that helped us out in the past.
I'd like to thank everyone who helped us get here and everyone who followed us throughout our experience in Kentucky Lake. I also like to thank Ardent Reels, Dude Wipes, and
yeah, the bros and Mr. Hoover and all
yeah,
the guys that keep it up.
Because without the Junior Bassmasters, we most likely wouldn't be here. Because without them, high school fishing in Louisiana wouldn't be a thing. They've very helped us a lot, helped us succeed in the bass fishing world.
Ian McGowan with Apex Fishing Charters. Went out today CCA for opening of Amberjack season. I think the biggest problem you have is avoiding a red snapper. If you can get some live hardtails and getting some platforms, some structure in 250 feet of water deeper, I don't think you have any problem catching your limit. There's plenty of big jacks. We had some up to 84 pounds today, and I'm sure it'll continue until the season shuts down next year.
KD, here we are going on right now. Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report, and let me say, I'm glad I got you here because I don't know what your work schedule, how you do, but one day a week somewhere you find a way to go fishing.
Hey, as soon as we finish this, in fact, I'm heading to Delacroix because, hey, the bite's been all down there. Jack was saying he's got a lot of bait in Sweetwater. Come on down, but finally that river's eased up that pressure to where black bass turned on some really nice trout. Inshore, hey, they still get you can get a Christmas trip in. You catch bass and catch reds. I mean, you can sight fish them, you know, Lake Leary, Lost Lake, Spanish Lake. A lot of fish there, Grand Lake. I mean, there's really a lot of fish out there.
A lot of people go there, and they always tell you it ain't nothing good about a west wind in Delacroix or Brenton Sound, but there's been a lot of fish that are being caught right now, and they're moving out. But what got me excited, Jax had his girl call me and say, by the way, inshore, in the marsh, there's a lot of undersized trout.
You better
So they want to catch bigger, they ought to go out. But he said, what that indicate, come the fall, we're going to be some perfect size trout to fish in close.
They're right at 11 and a half inches.
That's right, stay in the marsh. So if you look down at Grand Isle where we were fishing this down there, offshore was very good. You see that? You pick your days, pick your weather. All the fish in Grand Isle that I talk to, all the captains, are running west. I talk to Zudy, Unson.
Yep.
Every day but one, they had a limit of trout. And what's amazing about him, he don't go nowhere without some croaker.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? But they've been catching them on plastics. They know what he's using? Plain old sparkle beetle, the smoke-colored beetle with the sparkles in it, with the black, I mean, with the red dot in it. And he keeps them by the back. He was showing me. He said, "Gary." I said, "Mr. Zudy, what you doing? You tell me." He said, "There ain't no secret. There ain't no science. You got to find the good water. You're going in right now." I seen hyacinth in Bridgeside Marina. So he dives in that water, but they've been catching. Almost all the guys are running west, West Timberlake, fishing out front too, not in the back. And they're catching that, catching bigger trout.
With the river high, so much fresh water intrusion from a chow fly in Mississippi River with this high water, it's just pushing that real saltier water to the west. But we've seen fish like I haven't seen in the early 80s. Get caught out there. I mean, we had all these small trout for years around Grand Isle. They've been catching some really hefty trout.
I haven't had a report this week from Big Lake, but all the way to the east, Venice right now is starting to get hot, the river falling down. You saw where Dudley and Ed Sexton and all them caught them big trout. Now, they're going out.
They don't fish but anything but big trout. Excess don't fish
well,
all
they,
day for
they
two fish
months. In rigs. They, you know, he's talking about helicopter bait. That's an old story, and I don't want to take too long to tell you. One day I'll tell you about helicopter bait. But they fish in those rigs. They finding those rigs that them big trout stay in, and they going out further. Naturally, they ain't being influenced much about the river.
You know, we did a show called Hog Tide one time, and I want to just toss out to Boo Lejeune's family. Passed away a week ago, and he was one of these guys that just lived to fish those big old trout. So our hearts are with you, and our prayers are with y'all. But he had that Zwadavi joy of life spirit. Hey, that's what we do.
You had a friend that just had successful surgery, too.
Yep. Frenchie just had his cataract surgery. Get well, my friend. He said, "Mike, you can call me Frenchie." You know why? Yeah. Being from Cecilia.
But I'm telling you
Look,
what.
I want to thank you for letting me come on and visit with you while Don's out.
Oh, man, you did me a pleasure. But where are you going?
I'm heading straight to Delacroix. I got a daughter in. Got one of her friends in from Columbia.
Where are you going with your business right now? You cooking everywhere. Where you got... Big parties coming up? What?
Look, we strive for excellence. We do a lot of good stuff. Football season's around the corner. You know.
How can they get in touch with you?
Hey, chefkd.com, 205-COOK, 205-2665.
You're so entertaining anyway. You tell them a fish story. I believe you can put them on fish.
I think we put them on fish.
Okay, let's go to freshwater real quick. Now,
Bob Black's still okay. The water's still up. You got a lot of area there. It's getting ready to turn on in a lot of areas, but you got to be careful with fresh water. When that spillway and all this water system is going to start to drop, you have a lot of clear water coming out the swamps. Stay away from it. If you can read a beer can at the bottom of 6 foot, you don't want to fish there. You want to get right where any kind of river and water is mitten with some swamp water. You have some intermediate water there. That's where they're going to be.
If you see bubbles and in there and you catching shoepick,
yeah, if you see bubbles, get out.
Get out. But I'm going to tell you what. Don't be afraid to fish that muddy water and when it's mixing, especially when it's out, because it's pulling them crawfish and them stuff trying to get out of there and not get caught in them woods. And
look, I'll tell you one of my secrets. In the summertime, under normal conditions, I fish water that usually looks like chocolate milk. And that's where you catch them big old mean white bass. We don't want to, we call them fish sticks. I'm not into all them little fish sticks. I want to catch something pulls.
I promise y'all next week I'm going to bring you some stuff from the Oxbows all the way up north. I'm going to have a report coming from Minden. I'm going to have some things coming from Bissonneau. And by the way, they're drawing down a lot of those lakes right now. If you go to Wildlife and Fisheries thing, some of your favorite lakes are being drawn down right now to get rid of some of them aquatic vegetation. So what I can say is go out there, Cass, and thank KD one more time. KD, you got one thing you want to leave him with?
Zwadavi, Louisiana. If we don't have the joy of life here, man, you just missing something.
Come back next week. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
For 2016, Abu Garcia has come out with a new Revo Toro Beast. And they have it in a 50 size and a 60 size in low speed all the way to high speed. and some and also available in a left-hand retrieve. You got an infinity brake design, you got a power stack carbon matrix drag system. It comes with a power handle or your two-handed handle. The reel is an oversized low profile reel that gives you the features of a round ambassador reel, catching mangrove, red snapper, AJs, anything you want out there. You've got 8 bearings. You got your inches of, you got 24 inches to 34 inches of line, depending on which reel you have coming in on each revolution. Your maximum drag, 25 pounds. That is a lot of drag. The Abu Garcia Revo Toro Beast bait casting reel.